It's Absolute Radio at the V Festival, and joining me now from Plan B, Ben, hello.
Hey man, how you doing?
I'm all right, you're all done, you're all finished,
all
that's
finished,
it.
All finished, yeah.
And you played in Staffordshire yesterday, but you were here by last night.
Yeah, I had some promo to do with Chasing Status, and then I went and done a gig with them.
So what was that? I mean, was that a mad dash getting from Staffordshire to here?
It was a little bit, and I'm working on my film that I'm shooting in September as well. So I had a storyboard artist in the car with me, drawing pictures of the shots from the film, and it's been relentless.
Do you not get travel sick when you do that?
Well, I asked him if he did, because I mean, he's the one drawing.
So
was just saying, describing, you know, how the shots looked and stuff. And then last night after the show, we sat on the bus and done some more, and I'm going to do some more now. It's literally like I'm shooting on September the 1st, and it's a race against time to get everything ready, and it's a really small budget film. So there's a lot riding.
And do you involve yourself in everything with the films? Do you like even in
you
terms
got
of getting? And what about like getting the money together? Because it's dear.
Well, obviously I have management to do that. You know, this is like a microwave fund. So half of it is given to you by Microwave Film London, which is, you know, you have to make the film for 100 grand. So they give you 50 grand.
Yeah.
And you have to get the other 50 from somewhere else. And I've managed to do it where I'm funding it myself.
Yeah.
And that's not to say I'm a rich bloke. I've had to do a couple of other deals, you know, to kind of fund it myself. And it's still not enough money. You know, it's a very ambitious script.
It's weird because, you know, I suppose if people are listening, they think, oh, 100 grand, that's a load of money. Where does that go? But there's just
when you think about how many people it takes to make a film, literally hundreds, right?
Yeah.
And so we can only afford to pay everyone like national minimum wage, which is like 58 quid a day.
Yeah.
So it's like communism, right? So I get paid the same amount as the extras.
Yeah.
And so every time you have someone officially on your film, you've got to pay them that £58.
No
one's allowed to work for free. We've got to this point where, you know, I've got the first AD saying, look, we've got too many extras in this scene. It's costing us too much money. I'm like, they're my mates. They'll do it for free. And they're like, no, it doesn't work like that. They have to get paid.
Because of the union rules and
exactly,
stuff.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, it's ambitious, man. So it's a lot riding on this. Because, like, if I don't pull this off, then I don't think anyone's ever going to take a risk on me again in terms of directing, you know. And I know I'm good working with actors and I'm good at writing stories, but I'm not so good when I don't have the time.
So do you ever stop then? Because with the music and the filming, and I read that you're doing some treatments for some comedy stuff as well, aren't you? Has that got a bit out of control?
I don't know where that come from. Like, you know, like about 4 years ago, before Rude Tube came out, there was a lot of my friends doing loads of funny stuff on their phones, and I came up with this concept for a TV show that kind of incorporated that, but was also, like, you know, based on the music that was about at the time, and just kind of funny stuff, like a cool kind of music kind of program. But we never done anything with it, and so it's weird. It's like, you know, 4 years later,
it suddenly comes out of nowhere,
written about as if, you know, like I'm writing a sketch show, and there's nothing to it. And my favourite comedy show is not Far Show. Not that
I'm not dissing it, but
you know, it's Peep Show. Peep Show is my favourite comedy show. Alan Partridge, something like that. So it's just weird, like.
It could have something to do with the fact that it's summer and there's no news about.
Yeah, but just call me up and ask me. You know,
what you're
you
up
know,
to.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, you know, like, you've got to look at stories and see the sentiment of them. If the sentiment's nice and some of the facts are wrong, then it's cool.
Yeah.
It's just like everywhere I go, oh, you're doing a comedy show? I'm like, no. Because it gets a little bit annoying, you know what I mean? But the sentiment was nice of the piece, you know. He spoke about Ill Manners, my film, what I'm doing, and, you know, bigged me up. So
what about the set? I don't know what you played today, but I know that when you're in Staffordshire yesterday, you did a little bit of Seal and a bit of Paolo Nutini and a bit of Eminem in the set. Do you plan those things, or do they just fall out while you're on stage?
They happen in rehearsal. You try a few things, and, you know, Faith SFX, my beatboxer, is just amazing. He's like a one man producer.
Yeah.
He produces with his mouth, you know, and on the bus he's constantly just writing these new kind of riffs and stuff, and I'm constantly getting the phone out and recording it, because these are just great ideas. I know that we could go in the studio as soon as all this is done, and we'd practically have an album finished.
And
so we try and incorporate kind of the best bits of the things that happen spontaneously on the bus into the show. And we have to rehearse them because it's all completely live.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, so, it's a mix between, you know, stuff happening spontaneously and then us working it to make sure it works in the show. And then sometimes I just put them on the spot, put them in the deep end and say, let's just do something completely off the cuff. Like we've done at the Big Chill.
Yeah, yeah.
We've done that, you know. Because we had one more song to go and I looked round and they were telling me we had 10 minutes. So I said, oh, we've got to fill 5 minutes of the show with something. And I just put them in the deep end. But I love doing that, man. Like I think, you know, even if you fail, at least you tried, you know what I mean?
I'm interested to know, like, so you seem so involved with every aspect of the different types of work you do. Once you've made something and it's out there, how much do you care about what happens to it?
Well, you know, the first album, nothing really happened with it, and I cared a lot. I was quite bitter about that, you know what I mean? And with this album, it's the complete opposite. It's just gone crazy.
Yeah.
But what I've realised is that, you know, this is the work part of it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And there's bits I enjoy of the work.
Yeah.
You know, like today, the gig and seeing how everybody enjoyed it and enjoying it myself on stage.
Yeah.
But I'm a creative person and I'm only really happy when I'm creating.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that's why I guess I've taken on so much by trying to make this film at the same time as promoting the record.
Yeah.
Because in order for me to stay happy, you know, I need to be creating, and that's what this film's allowing me to do. I'm still creating a vision, you know, but I understand the importance of promoting something that took me 3 years to make,
yeah.
which is why, you know, I'm also trying to fit all this in.
And the film's going to take up a lot of time, though, because you'll be filming it, of course, and then the editing process.
Well, I've only got 18 days. I've managed to get 18 days out of my schedule to shoot this film, which is not enough.
And what about getting it edited and ready, then?
Well, okay, so we're going on tour in October, UK tour, and then European tour in November.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take a editing bus on tour with me.
Wow.
And after every show, I'll have an editor waiting on the bus, assembling all the rushes.
Yeah.
And I'll just be sitting there editing with him while we drive to.
That's not what you think a musician's doing after a show.
Well, I'm not. That's the thing. I'm not just a musician.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I'm
yeah,
not
yeah.
just a rapper. I'm not just a singer. I'm all these other things and. And I get one life, you know.
And can you see yourself creating any more music in the near future then?
Yeah, big time. I mean, the stuff that, you know, the stuff that Faith as Effects has been coming out with on the bus, which is, I guess, dubstep.
Yeah.
Like, I love that stuff, you know. Yeah. I just love good music, and that's why I done a soul record, because at the time I was just making good soul music, you know, because I don't stop creative.
Yeah.
Flow. Like, if you know, I've written folk songs that are great. I've kind of written and produced a rock album with a friend of mine that was on the heroin. I got him off heroin and done this album.
And are you autonomous enough that there's no pressure from anywhere above that says, oh no, you better not do a dubstep album?
The only pressure's on me, really, because I just, anyone that tells me I can't do something, I say yes I can. And then it's like the pressure to prove them all wrong.
Yeah.
You know, and I know I can prove people wrong. I just need the time to do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what I'm, it's the only thing that's freaking me out about this film, is that I don't have the time to prove all the cynics wrong. You know, about whether or not I'm capable of directing. And I am. I am. I know I am. You know, it's just if I had a big budget, then I'd be sweet. You know, but I don't. So I've got to try and make this work on what I do have, and to be honest, everything I've directed so far, the pieces, music video with Chasing Status, and the short film that no one saw because it's actually part of this feature, was done on you know, peanuts. You know, pieces was shot for £1,400, and my first short was shot for £4,000. You know what I mean? So like, I'm used to kind of having
being
them restrained, and it kind of makes it more creative, because you kind of have to think of you know, different ways of getting not what you wanted, but something equally as good, you know.
Well, good luck with the film. And I was going to say, enjoy some time off, but you're not getting any time off for a long time, are you?
For about a year and a half, I think it's going to be like this.
Right,
I'm happy, man.
So Ben, thank you very much.
Cheers, brother.